When Sputnik was launched, that woke everybody up.
The whole idea of Navy navigation satellites was born out of watching Sputnik.
The Transit Satellite Navigation System was first launched on September 17, 1959. But the idea of transit came from listening to a Russian satellite.
The Sputnik launch was tracked by two guys at APL.
Those two guys at APL were PhDs William Guier and George Weiffenbach.
And they tracked that first Sputnik satellite and found that the satellite was behaving according to a physics principle called the Doppler shift. And the motion of the spacecraft caused the Doppler shift. It's as if you're standing on a railroad platform. You hear the train signal begin to get sharper, and then when it goes past you, it begins to get deeper. Well, they took that to Frank McClure, their supervisor at the time, who said, if you can figure out the orbit of that satellite based on the Doppler shift, we ought to be able to turn that problem upside down and figure out where we are.
In just one weekend, the concept of a global navigational satellite system was born. In March 1958, McClure took the Transit Satellite Navigation System idea to the Navy, promising it would be accurate within 1/10 of a mile. On September 17, 1959, Transit Satellite 1A launched from Cape Canaveral.
Unfortunately, the third stage of the rocket ship did not ignite, so we didn't go into orbit. But we got about 20 to 25 minutes worth of precious tracking data, which was enough to validate the concept of Doppler tracking.
Less than 7 months later, Transit 1B was launched.
Transit 1B was the first one that went into orbit, a fantastic accomplishment that early in the space program. Every 3 or 4 months, we were back at the Cape ready for a launch. And of course, the system required 4 of those in polar orbits, displaced such that we had complete coverage on the surface of the Earth. Transit enabled the subs to stay essentially submerged, and they never had to reveal their position.
Transit went operational as the U.S. Navy's principal navigation system in 1964. At that moment, Transit became OSCAR.
OSCAR was the Navy's designation for operational, O for operational.
Vice President Hubert Humphrey authorized public release of the Transit Navigation System in 1967, and it was used by thousands of commercial and private seagoing vessels for decades.
Some of those transits probably lived for over 25 years. They had a 5-year life design goal. They aged very gracefully.
In 1996, after more than 30 years in service, the Transit Satellite Navigation System was replaced by today's GPS.
It was a fantastic system.